ماشي مش
हेलो एवरीवन, गुड आफ्टरनून। सॉरी फॉर द लेट, इट वाज अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम इन इंटरनेट। सो लेट मी स्टार्ट टुडे सेशंस। इन टुडे सेशंस वी आर गोइंग टू नो अबाउट द फाइल टैब एंड द प्रोटेक्शंस ऑफ द वर्कबुक, वर्कशीट एंड अदर फ्यू कॉन्सेप्ट्स। And I think all has been logged in. So a little bit, we'll wait for other few seconds. I'll let them all to add. Okay, let me start our session. Last class we have started that what is on Microsoft, who has been introduced it, and we have seen the how to open the Excel, what is an important of Excel. All these things we have discussed last class. So we are going to be next one is then how to use an Excel workbook or worksheet. So first of all, let me again show how to open the Excel sheet. So let me close this Excel sheet. So we'll be having a three ways of opening that we already know that. Let go with the startings. Go with the start button. You can select the Excel. You'll be having and all the programs will be having a Excel over here. You can select here. So it is on one way. The second way, you can go by the and run command. It is a run prompt. You can click on window R button. You can type there only the Excel. Click on OK. This is the second way. The third way, you have an right click on your desktop. You can click on new. You will be having a Microsoft Excel workbook. You can open by like this also. But if you open by the right click and by the new, it will be saved automatically on the desktop. So you can alter it or you can change the name of the file. Okay. So let me delete it. So we'll be open a new workbook, window or Excel. And last class we have seen how to edit this template. So we don't want to again go with this. Let me go with a blank workbook. I already explained that why we need a Excel to make an enter the date. Which are the date? For data kind of, if you are an HR, if you want to write and all the employees data, you can present over there. Or if you are working as a warehouse, you can have all the products names, all the materials names over there, your cost of it, or the quantity of it, you can write over there. Or if you are working as in hospital, if you want to present and medicines or any kind of other items, if you want to write on the worksheet, you can write over there. So let me go with how to open the workbook. So this is a workbook. So blank workbook, we are going to be select the blank workbook. Okay, this is your screen. So which are the concepts we are going to be? All the participants, just mute your mic. Whoever unmuted, I'll just log out your classes. Okay, let me go with the notepad. So we are going to be no good today. The screen element or screen component we are going to be doing. And the next concept we are going to be do with the file tab. and we are also going to be new today, and which are the another sheets, how to add the sheet, how to move it. We are going to deal with the sheet tab also. So first of all, let me introduce what are the elements of the component, elements of the Excel sheet. Okay, so can you see here? Minimize, maximize, close. This is called as an office button. This is called as a minimize, maximize, close. Minimize will be if you click on minimize, automatically it will be minimized in your taskbar. You can select it. Maximize, it will be fitted in off of your window, and close, it will close your program. And this is called as an display ribbon bar. And which are the ribbons? What you can see, this file, home, insert, this is called as an tabs. Under each tabs, it will be having a subcommands called as an cut, copy, paste. And each command has been grouped as an clipboard font. This three together will called as an ribbons. Again, I'll repeat. Ribbons, it's nothing but the tabs, commands, and group. The three together will called as an ribbons. So if you want, if you do, when you're presenting any data, if you don't want to display this ribbon bar in your presenting, you can hide it. How to hide? That you can do by the display options. Okay, that you can see that in the display options, we'll be having the three major concepts. How to hide the ribbon, show tabs and command. First, let me see the auto hide the ribbon. Once you click on how to hide the ribbon, automatically what you can see, this tabs, commands and groups will be hide it. Just see, just click on how to hide the ribbon. Can you see the ribbon and commands has been hide it. Let me get back off it. Again, you need to click on this display ribbon option only. Let me click on that display option. Click on show tabs. The show tabs, it will only display the tabs. It won't display any tabs or it won't display any commands or groups. If you want to get back of your tabs and commands, you need to go back to display option. You need to click on show tabs and commands. Okay. Next, we have a next concept. Let me go with the sheet. This is called as a title bar. You can see that defaultly, which has a name called as a book. So which has been have already, it has selected a two workbook. So which has a book one and book two. Okay. This is a default file name. You can change it according to it. So how to change the file name? Let me see later towards. This is called as a QCQT. It's nothing but quick access toolbar. So QAT, it's nothing but quick access toolbar. Why we need this quick access toolbar? To make an easy working process. For example, see, in the insert tab, I have a power client over here. Or see, I have a review, or I have a, some kind of other in a reference tab. Let me go with the reference tab. So can you see that in the review tab, we have a spell check over in a review tab. See, if I am in cases, if I am using an ribbon bar or if I am using any text, if I have a spelling mistake, I used to come for the review tab. I need to click on a spellings. Instead of it, you can make easily on the title bar that you can make by the quick access toolbar. Okay, you can see number of uncommands you have over here. It is a new, open, save, mail, spelling check, other few commands over there, you can select it. For example, already we have a save button, we have an macro button, we have a deleting of cells. And if you want to make an other commands, you can make it an easy form. Like for example, you have a more commands, you can click over there. Which are the commands you want to make regularly you will use, you can select it. For example, you want to use a copy, I'll just add it over here. So if I want to add an always I'll use for the cut and copy, always I'll use a sort and filtering. Sort and filtering is nothing but you are going to be assigning your data as an ascending to descending. These are the commands which I'll use regularly. You can select it and you can click on add and you can click on OK, which will be assigned in quick access toolbar. Okay, click on OK. Can you see that we have an ascending descending? For example, I'll write a data over here. For example, as in brand as in Vivo, I'll add an Oppo. and I'll add as an Redmi. I'll add as an Redmi. See, is this not as assigning as an ascending or descending? Means I'll A to Z or Z to A. If I want to assign it sorting form, you can click on it. It will ask which form you want. Do you want in ascending to descending or descending to ascending? Select which form you want and click on OK. Automatically, which will be assigned it. Okay, this is called as a quick access toolbar. You can go by over here and you can click on quick access toolbar. Can you see over here? We have a, this is called as a quick access toolbar. That's an QAT. Okay, click on over here. Which are the commands which will be used by the regularly? You can activate over here. Or instead of, if you don't want, if I want to hide it, you can go by the more commands back again. Whichever you don't want, select it, click on remote. That's it. It will be removed. Where I can display over this? I can display over this one by the title bar at your left edge of the corner. Okay, so you can see over here, left above the corner, you can see over this custom ribbon bar. If you don't want to display on the top, you can assign after this ribbon bar. This I'll show you. Just click on a quick access toolbar. Can you see that? Show below the ribbon, you can click automatically, which will assign into the down towards of your ribbon bar or be above your formula bar. Okay, so let me close this. Let me assign it to the above only. Okay, so again I'll repeat, this is called as an office bar, office button. This is called as an display ribbon. This is called as an quick access toolbar, QAT, and this is called as an tab, which will be named as a file, home, insert, and design other, which has been assigned. Okay, so let me go by the one by one. And in the home tab, can you see that some of the few other commands will be there. Cut, copy, paste, format, painter, bold, italic, underline, which has been assigned as a group. There is a font, clipboard, alignment. Okay, next we have a formula bar. This is called as a formula bar. Whatever you are going to be write in a particular cell, which can be displayed over in a formula bar. For example, if I use a rand between, which has been explained in the last class, rand between, just assign the rand between, give a bottom number and give a least number, highest number, click on enter. See, the formula is displaying on a formula bar and the data is displaying a cell. Okay, this is called as a name bar, name box or name bar, which will be having a cell address of the cell address. For example, see, if I cursor in the A, it displaying as an A1. If I cursor in the F4, it will display as an F4. In case I want to go for now the cell of F6, it will take you to H6. Instead of, I don't want to go with H6, I want to go for I2. Okay, it will take you particularly I2. Means, in always, if I'm writing in a name box, you have to be assigned the first as in row heading, sorry, first as in column heading, and the row, second one will be the row heading. You have to be mentioned. For example, what is in column name? Column name which has been assigned as in A, B, C, and your rows has been assigned as in 1, 2, 3. So always your names in a name box, it will display the first the column name, then it will display the row name. Okay, so let me show you other one more time. Okay, I want to go for J3. This seat will take you to a J3. Okay, so like this, wherever you cursor the name box, in a name box, it will display. Next, we know that we have a number of rows and number of columns, which you can see over here. Number of columns which has been named as in A, B, C, D. And can you see it is an ended by the, after the A to Z, it will be ended by the AA, AB. It will continue by the AA, AB. The last column name will be the HFD. Okay, I think you have clear. The last column name will be the XFT. If you want to get back of here, again the first cell or first column, you have to go by the control right arrow. So you can use your arrows to switch within your worksheet. So if you use the control plus down arrow, it will take you to the end of the column, end of the row. It will shift. If you use the control plus right arrow, it will take you to the end of the column and end of the row. Okay, you can switch by using of your arrows, control with arrows. And let me see, this is called as an sheet bar. This sheet bar, you can see defaultly we have a sheet one. If you want to add a sheet, you can click on this plus. Okay, either you can use the shift, you can use this plus, or you can add by the shift F11 is an one more shortcut key you can use it. One more method you have, you can insert the sheet, that is an right click. You have a insert, you will be having a workbook, you can select it, you can click on open. Okay, so this is my three methods you can insert the sheet. So see, here have a plus button, you can click on a plus button. One method, you can click on shift F11 and shortcut key to add a sheet, or you can use a one more method, that is a right click, and you can use a insert tab, you can use a worksheet. Okay, then if you want to delete the sheet, other things we'll see later towards. This is on status bar. The status bar will be having an view button, which can be displayed by the different viewing. This is a normal view, this is a print layout view, this is a reading view. Okay, different viewing buttons we have. This is called as a zoom button, which can be zoomed out or zoom in. Instead of using of this zoom bar, you can use a control scroll up, and you can use control scroll down. So I'm again repeating, if you want to zoom in, control scroll up you can use, control scroll down you can use it. Okay, there's another method you can use. So next, let me go with the how to save the file, how to do other things. Okay, so let me go with the file tab. So let me see by the one by one. In our tabs, we have a file, home, insert, page layout, formula, date. For example, file, we're going to be save, we are going to be protect our document. In a home, we are going to be formatting our data. We have a condition formatting. We are going to be auto sum, other things we'll do. In an insert tab, we'll be having a pivot table that we can analyze our huge data complex data into a simplified manner. We have a charts over here, and different kind of charts we have. We can use that one. In a page layout, whatever you're going to be, taken hard copy of your printing, you can be change your margins, or you can change the size of your papers. Other page setup we can do over here. And using a formula, we have a different kind of formula, like a mathematical, statistical, lookup function, logical function we are going to be doing in this. And in our data tab, we have analyzing the data with the differently. And we have in this filter, we have a sort and filter we have over here. Data, what if analysis we have, we are going to be analyze our data. Like this, we have a different kind of work process. And we have a review. Under that, you can go by the spell check, treasures, other concepts we have. And we have a view button. In a view button, you will be having an macros, you can record your data. Like this, we have a different kind of concepts. So first of all, let me go by the one by one. Under that, let me go by the file tab. Okay, in a file, we have a home. Once we have opened the Microsoft Excel, we can view this screen. That is, and we have a template. We can use this template. Already have shown you that how to use the calendars, how to use an other kind of attendance. We have an budgets. We can use that templates. Otherwise, you can go by the new blank work. And also, you can see that recent document. In case of we have saved your document, I forgot that where I have saved the data. So you can go come over here, and you can see here the recent workbooks where you have saved. For example, have the saved in desktop, has saved in C drive, has saved in download. Some of the few days data you can view over here. And we have a new, that is a nothing but template also you can view, and you can select by the new blank workbook. Okay, then we have a open, that's nothing but whichever data you have saved in any folder or any kind of drives or anywhere in a document or desktop, you can view over here. For example, see, in a workbook has the workbook has saved in desktop, bills have riser, some balance sheet have riser, some joining letters have created in Excel, and have some other kind of sheets over here. That those are the things you can see over in a open, means whichever data you have saved, you can select by the open. The shortcut key for opening the new sheet is called as a Control plus N to open the new workbook. To open a new workbook, you can use a Control plus N to open an already used form. For example, I'm using an Excel right now. I want to view the another kind of Excel workbook. Or for example, I want to use an some balance sheet. I want to open the balance sheet. You can click on Control O directly from the worksheet. So if you click on Control O, it will take you to the and recent saved over here. So for example, I want to open the balance sheet. I can open the balance sheet. I can view that where you are, the previous workbook, which will be available in the taskbar only. You can select it. Okay. So shortcut key for shortcut key for open Control plus O to save your document. So Control N for open. Sorry, Control N for new workbook. Control O for open. You have a Control N. To save this, we'll use a Control plus yes. There'll be a two method of saving. One is in save, and one more you have a save as. Control S for save. We have a save as. We'll use a function key F12. Okay. We'll use a function key F12 for save as. Okay. What is the difference between save and save as? I'll just explain you. Save. If you are, I'm asking you all to please note down this shortcut key, which will be helpful for the future. So please note, make a note of this shortcut key. Okay. So let me start how to save the document. You can see over here, we have a save and save as. Save will be used for save a document for one time. Save as, which will be helpful to save your document in other drives. For example, D drive I want to save. I want to save in C drive. Or whether I have saved the document as in first time in a desktop. Same thing I want to save in a D drive or documents. That you can, this save has will be helpful. Just I'll show you. I'll just have a data over here. I'll save this. Save, shortcut keys, then Control S. Click on Control S. It will ask whether where you want to save. Whether it's an document or desktop or downloads. If you don't know, click on browse. It will show you which drive you want to save. Select over here either the document, either you want in a desktop, either you want in a C drive or D drive, wherever you want, you can save. For example, see, on the desktop I am saving the file. And always when you're saving the data, you have to give your file name. For example, this is a mark sheet. So let me give its books. This book is belong to mark sheet. Okay. Let me give mark sheet, save it. And you need to give an extension, that is an XLS. What is an extension? Is nothing but in which format you are going to be save a data. For example, we are going to be save a data in Excel. So I'm giving an Excel SX is an extension. Excel SX is an extension to save a data. Click on save. Automatically it will save the data where I can find. I'll just close this data. So can you see the mark sheet which has been named on? You can open and you can reuse it. The same sheet, the same data which used to be saved in a other place or either other document. See, I'll just update other thing. I have given a Redmi, Oppo, Vivo. I'll give other brand like can, for example, other name I'll give a Jioni or Honor. I'll give a other name. Just if I click on a Control S, it will be updated, but it won't be saved in other path. If you want to save this data in a multiple times, you can give an F12, that is in save as. Once you have used F12, so it automatically asks you, do you want to save it where? Can you see that above? Save as. Okay, so you can give a same file name and you can give a save it in other form. For example, I'm saving in a document. Okay, if you are using in your laptop, I'm requesting you all to use the function key, that is an FN key and F12 function key. Okay, if you are without using a FN function key, it won't be applicable. Means it can't be a save as, will won't be work. Okay, means shortcut key. If you use this method, means if you went with the tabs, you can will be work. If you're using a shortcut key, that is an F11, F12, that is in save as. If you want to use the F12 function key, you need to use a FN plus F12 function key. Okay, I'm that clear. So next, let me see that under the file tab, we have left the info. We have to do the info. So let me see that. So if you are an, imagine if you are working in an other workplace, for example, you are an HR, your other colleagues will send the data to you, okay? Your other colleagues will send data to you. For example, you are in working as an HR. Your other colleagues will send the data to you. It is a very important data. Then, for example, you are going to be sending for them. It should be unprotected. Means whatever the data is, all the whenever the worksheet is exchanging from one by one, it should be a protected. If you want to protect the document, there is a different kind of protection. One is you can protect by the you can protect the overall workbook. One more thing, you can protect a sheet, and you can protect a structure of workbook. So this all, and also you can protect the particular cell that will be see later towards. These are the other method you can be protected. Okay, one is an workbook, one is an you can protect the sheet, one you can protect the structure. Okay, that how we'll see here. So okay, you need, if you want to protect your workbook, you need to go with the file, you need to go with the info. Under the info, can you see protect the workbook? Just select the protect the workbook. Here we have a different kind of protection. First is allow open read only mode. For example, whenever you are going to be editing your document, it should ask, do you want to edit or you want to not edit? If you want to ask, you can select by the read only mode. Just see, allow read only mode. I have given, it's already protected. I'll save this data, I'll close it. See, again, I'll open the same data. It will ask me to, do you want use by the read only mode? Sorry. Info. Allow editing mode. Save this data. Close it. Again, you open the same workbook. See, the author would like to open mark sheet as read only unless you need to make a changes. Open as read only. If you want, you can click on read only mode. If you don't want, you can click on no, and you can remove that always. Whenever you're going to be login, and if you have selected your workbook, automatically it will ask, do you want to open in a read only mode? If you don't want, you can go with the file. You can remove that read only mode. This is an other method. You can change it. Okay. So next, in info, you have a protection. Under the protection, you have a protect current sheet. You can select the protect current sheet. You just need to give a password over here. This I'll show you one more time. If you want to protect your workbook, means we have a number of sheets over here. So all the sheet has to be protected. Nobody has to be view this data. If I have given the password only, they used to be edited. If you want, you can go by the file. You can go to file. Under the file, you have an info. Under the protect workbook, you can go by the encrypt with password. Click on encrypt with password. Write a password which will be included by the both the alpha and the numeric. For example, 123. Give a enter. Give a re-enter the password. Now save the file, and I'll show you. Just I'll close it. And if I open the workbook, it will open by, see, it's protected. If you have given the password only, it will open. In case of, if you have forgotten the password later towards after the few months, I didn't use this workbook, automatically will forget the password. In case of if you forgotten the password, you can rectify that file by, if you have know the hardware networking, you can rectify that file, okay? Present, I'll give a password. See, I'm giving a wrong password. I'm not giving an what exactly I have given when I'm saving. See, that password is an incorrect. Either you have used it by the caps lock or not. Okay, let me open one more time. It's asking password. See, the back side, no, you can't view any kind of data. Sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, whatever the sheets I have added, I can't be viewed. So you can go by the sheet. You can add a password, click on enter. Now you can view your sheets. That is a protection. It is a one kind of protection. Just I'll again repeat. If I want to protect your workbook, that is an overall your workbook. If you want to protect, you can go by the file. Under the file, you have an info. You can go by the work protect workbook. Click on encrypt password. Give a password. Re-enter the password and save it. Later towards, if you want to remove your password, same path you need to go. File, info, protect, click on encrypt with password, remove the password, click on OK and save the file. Whenever you are going to be add the password, whenever you are going to be and decrypting the password, you should save the file. Okay, that is an info protection. And one more protection we have, it is an protect the current sheet. I'm going to be encrypting or I'm going to be authenticate my particular sheet. See, for example, I have a number of sheets, sheet 1 to sheet 8 I have. Under that, I want to protect only a sheet 2. Just for example, I'll add some names over here. Anu, Suma, Hema. I'll just add a names over here. Suma, Anu, Karthik. Okay, I'll add some name. I need to protect only this sheet. I should not protect any sheet 1, sheet 4, sheet 5. I just want to protect only that sheet 2. If I want to protect this, you can go by the file, you can go by the info, you can go by the protect workbook. Under that, protect current sheet. So here you can see password to be unprotected sheet. You need to give one password. It is any other password which will be included by the both alpha and numeric, and check whenever you're going to be protecting your worksheet, you need to check lock it cell and unlock it cell has been selected or not. You need to be manually selector, or in cases if it already selected, don't worry, click it on OK. Re-enter the password for the confirmation. Click on OK. Okay, so password is incorrect. Let me again write it. 123 is a password. Click on OK. Re-enter the password. Click on given OK. Okay, so which has been saved. See, I'm going to sheet 2. See, I'm going to be editing a data. I'm going to sheet 4. I'm going to be editing the sheet 4. But in the sheet 3, it won't allow you to edit. Why? Because already have authenticated the particular sheet. Either you can authenticate the overall workbook or you can go by the particular sheet. So you can both, you can do by the file under the info, you can go by the protect workbook, you'll be having a protect sheet. If you want to remove, same path, file, info, under the protect workbook, select the protect current sheet and enter the password which you have given for protecting the current sheet. This is one more method you can be had it. Okay, so next we can go with the other method. You can protect your protect your structure of workbook. For example, nobody has to be added the sheet. See, if I click on F4, I can add the sheet. If I don't want sheet, I can remove it. So which are the sheets I want to remove, I can remove it. But I don't want to change anything. If I have sent my document to somewhere, or if I have sent my document to someone other, my colleagues or HR, or if I sent my higher authority, nobody has to be added or nobody has to be changed my other sheets or other data. So you can go by file, you can go by the info. Under the info, you will be having a protection. Under that, you will be having a protect workbook structure. So click on it. give a password. It may be an alphanumeric. The structure should be activated. Click on OK. Re-enter the password. Click on OK. Sorry. Click on OK. Re-enter the password. Just one more second. Sorry, I'm going to be authenticate this overall sheet. I'm going for the file, protect workbook, protect the workbook structure, give the password, re-enter the password, click on OK. Now see this. Can you see that? You can't be add the sheet. You can't be delete the sheet. See, can you see that? The sheet cannot be deleted, which has been hided. You can't be add the tab color. You can't be hide the sheet. You can't be rename it. Okay, so that is a structure. So I will again repeat. We have a three kinds of protect, different kind of protection. And you have a read only mode. Once you have logged in with your workbook or worksheet, it will ask you that if you want to open with a read only or not. Second thing, we have a protect the workbook. Overall, you are going to be protecting your workbook. And you have a encrypt with password that you are going to be protect your workbook. And the third, you have protecting the sheet. You can protect the particular sheet. And you have a protect workbook structure that can be protected only. Nobody has to be change the data, or nobody has to be delete your data, or nobody has to be add any sheets, or nobody has to be delete your sheets. That protections you can done by this structure. Okay, these are the other kind of protections we have over in a Excel. Okay, so next we have a save, that I have explained you what is in save and save as. So save is control has, save as F12. And history can't be displayed. History is defaultly in all the Microsoft application which has been added. Okay, don't worry. In a Word, Excel, PPT, in Access, all the history has been added. Don't worry about it. Next, we let me go with the print. Okay, in a print, so if you want to, first of all, if we have a number of copies, you can assign a number of copies. If I want 100 copies, we are in our class, we have a 72 members, we have a 75 members. I need to print, or I need to give all these documents to my friends or my colleagues. You can assign the number of copies you want. And this is a printer connection. You can connect by the connections. And you have a settings. Under that, you have a page setting is nothing but, one second, I have an freezer it. So I'll remove the protection of structure. I'll go with, if you have protection of structure, can you see that you can't view the preview of your workbooks or worksheet? So let me close that. I'll go with the info. I'll go with the protection. I'll remove the protect workbook. I'll remove this. I'll give a password. I'll remove it. Whenever you're going to be giving a password, you should be remember that what password have given it. Okay. So next, let me go with the file, and we have a print. Now, can you see that? Can't view it. Yes, it has been printed. Just a second. Let me close this. Let me select the new workbook. Door. Okay. So next, let me go with the file. Print. You can't find anything of a printing. Okay, let me add over here some data. It's not finding any data. So let me have a rand between. I'll add a least number. I'll add a highest number for the practical purpose that I showed you last class. You can use this fill handler. You can use this now. Let me go with the file. Let me go with the print. Yes. Now you can find it. Yes. So now you can see the data which you want to print. You can go by the file. You can print it over here. So for example, I'll select the huge document. Okay, here I have an April sheet. I have a huge data over here. So I want to print this data. Only I want to print only some structure. You can select some structure and you can print it. That I'll show you by later towards. Let me go with the file print. Let me go with the how to set up printing. Okay, so we have a, if you want to print all the sheets, you can print. You can see that we have a multiple pages. Whichever you want a current sheet, you can select the current sheet. Or if you want to print all the sheets, you can print all the sheets. So you have, you can see that print selected sheet. Only the particular sheet will be printed. Only sheet one will be printed. Either it won't be printed all the sheets. So print entire workbook means it will be printed overall 255 sheets. So select the particular sheet and you can assign it. Print a selected sheet means if you want to print only from the 2 to 10 or 1 to 5, you can assign over here. Okay. So whatever the sheets you want to print it, you can assign from the page 1 to page 1, I can print it. And then we have a collated and the unfoliated. What is collated, unfoliated? Well, we went with the selecting of printing. If you have given a collated, the paper printing will be your sheets. So imagine you have a 4 to 5 members. You want to print your document by the set of, means I have a 5 sheets. It should be printed by the set of. If you click on a collated, the sheet will be printed by the set by the boys. If you click on an uncollated, the printing will be given by the an individual set of sheets by the one by one. So you need to select an uncollated when you have selected the printing. Okay, so collated, I'll repeat, collated, if you want a set of papers, you can click on collated. Uncollated, if you want to print an individual sheet by that time, you can click on uncollated. Okay, then you have a protect sheet. Then you have a orientation in a page. We'll be having a two types of orientation. That is an portrait and the landscape. You can view over here. The portrait will be having a height wise. If you selected the landscape, it will be printed by the width wise. Okay. So you see the data, which will be printed by the width wise. If you selected the portrait, you'll get by the when you are selecting the printing setup, you can change this. Then we have an page that if you want to print your page page size, that is, and if you want a A4, A5, you can select this. In case of if you don't want a page setup, let it be A4, A5, or whatever you want. If you want to change your margins, so if I want a gutter positions, other thing, you can assign over here. For example, my margins will be default, it will be having a normal, that is then top 1.5 and bottom 0.7, bottom 0.7, left 0.7, and header footer will be printed by 0.7. If you want to change that, you can go by the custom margin, you can change over here. Okay. So whatever the margins I want to top 1 or top 2, you can manually add it or you can click on this drop down button. Okay, so this is a setup of your margins. Okay, this is your printing setup. And in case of if I want to send this through mail, okay, whatever I have created the sheet, I want to send through mail, you have a share button. You can go by the share, you can click on a mail. You'll be having a send by attachment. If you want to send this file by the attachment, you can click on send by attachment. Or if you want to click on send by the PDF, it will be converted into the PDF and it will be sent it to the particular one. And you always know to that, whenever you are going to be share your document or whenever you're going to be mail the document by the Microsoft Office in any applications, you must use the Outlook. Without Outlook, the message or mail cannot be sent. Okay. For example, I need to send by this attachment. Click on attach. Okay. Automatically, it will take you to the Outlook. Okay. See, it's asking for whom you need to send. Just I need to enter the mailing address. Okay. Automatically, the book has been attached or my workbook has been attached. Click on send. It will send it. Multiple people, you can send the mail. but always you need to know to be, make to be note that if you want to mail your document, it may be a Word, Excel, PPT, you must use a Outlook. Without Outlook, you can't be mail in a Microsoft package, Microsoft Office. Okay, so if you want to send by a PDF, there is no need of manually converting. Automatically, it will convert your data. Just can be viewed. Can you see this? I don't have a PDF opener, so it's converted in the Google form. So you can send by whoever you want to send. Okay, so it is a file. You have a share. You can share by Google, and we have a export. You can export your document by the PDF. So what is need of PDF? Why we need to convert your data to PDF? For example, just I have showed you how to change my margin. See, in case I have changed my margins into all top one, to bottom one, left and right as an one, which have assigned my data in my convention, means I have assigned my data according to my view or according to my data. So if I send as it is for them, if the other person has their margin with a differently, automatically your data will be split into other sheet or other row. So it should not be happened. It should be, and whatever I have sending the data, if they have to receive the same thing, you can convert that into the PDF. I'll give a best example that whatever you are going to be create the document, I have given an image in a one sheet one, I have given a document, I have given a header, I have given a title name, I have given a table of content, all the data has given over in the particular document which have been converted into the PDF. I have sent it to the someone, so automatically what they have their own margins, it will be converted into it. So whatever the you have given the content, automatically it will be switcher. So if it should not be happened, so whatever you are going to be send the data the same as it is they want to receive, you can go with the create a PDF format, click on it, it will ask where you want to save. You can select the document or the desktop, give a file name, click on publish. Okay, so automatically it will be saved. You can see on my desktop. Can you see it? Book one is saved. Okay. So next we have an close, that the sheet will be, your document will be closed. Okay. And we have other mode. Just one second. We have a file and we have a close. You can select the close. Close will be closed your document. If you went with the mode, you'll be having an account. If you want to view which version you have, who has been activated, you can see over here. Okay. Then you have an, in a more, we have a feedback. You can give your data feedback to your Microsoft Office, and you can give, you have an option. In this options, we have to know under different concepts. So let me see on by the next class. Okay. But I need to do this on the sheet tab today. So let me do this sheet tab. Okay, here I have some of the sheets. Let me add a sheet. Okay, let me select the new workbook. I selected the new workbook. We know that before 2007, it was having a defaultly and three worksheet. Okay, before 2007. 2007, it was totally having a three worksheets. Okay, so how many sheets? Three worksheets we used to have. After 2007, we used to have an only one sheet. After 2007, okay, one sheet we used to have. You can see we are using 2016 version. We have defaultly sheet one. If you add, you can go by the plus. Okay. In the right click of your sheet tab, you'll be having the insert. You can delete your data. You can rename. You can move your sheet and you can copy, or you can be protect your sheet that already we have did in a file tab. You can give a tab color. You can hide your sheet and you can select all the sheets. So how do you do this? Let me see. Okay, let me go with the sheet. Let me see how to insert the sheets. So in the insert the sheets, we have a different kind of sheets. There's an insert the workbook. We have a chart. We can insert the sheets like in chart. We can insert the macros chart, macros Excel sheet we can add. We have an other kind of templates we have seen the last class. All the templates you have over here, blue budgets, grocery list, other things we have over here, you can use it. For example, if you have selected the chart, if you click on OK, you can insert the sheet that is related to chart. Okay, that we'll see later towards when we are doing the insert tab we have over here, we'll see on that time. Okay, so let me have how to insert the sheet. There is an shift F11 one method, either you can click on plus, either you can click on right click, you can insert the sheet. In case of I don't want the chart sheet right now, I can select, I can click on a delete. Automatically the sheet will be deleted, the workbook won't be deleted. Don't worry about that. If you have given a right click on the sheet tab and to click on a delete. Okay, then what I have given the sheet name, that if you want to edit it, you can click on a delete. Sorry, if you want to edit, rename the sheet, you click on a rename, and you can change the sheet name as an marks one book, or if I want to add the next sheet, I can add over here. Either you can double tap on it, either you can right click on it, and you can right click and you can click on a rename also. Okay, so let me right click on it, rename the file as a marks two. Okay, as it is, you can add multiple sheets. Okay, I'll add over here marks three. Okay, whatever the sheets you want, you can add it. Okay, next, on the right click sheet tab, we have delete, we have remove, we have completed delete, we have completed rename, and we used to move this sheet to the next. For example, mark sheet one is in first, mark sheet two is in second, mark sheet three is in third. I want to shift this marks one in between of mark sheet one, in between of marks two and marks three. How to move this? Right click on the particular sheet, select the particular sheet, right click on it and click on a move or copy. Okay, so select the sheet which you want to move. So if you want to move the sheet, you need to select in what before you want to select. You want to send, I want before the sheet 3, so have selected the sheet 3. Okay, click on OK, which has been assigned on marks 2 and marks 3. Okay, now I want to move this sheet 3 into between of marks 2 and marks 1. Okay, select the sheet 3. I'll click on right click, move or copy. I want to move between a marks 2 and marks 3. If I want to send this before of it, I need to select the marks 1. Okay, click on OK, it will be sent. Okay, next you have a right click on the sheet tab. You can click on a protect sheet. Already we have did this, there is no need of again doing. And right click, we have a tab color. So when you are going to be designing, when you are going to be showing your document to some of your authority, you can change your tab colors. You're not going to be change your sheet color. You're going to be change your tab sheet tab color. Okay, right click on it, tab color, select the which color you want to be present. So select the each and every sheet and change the colors. Okay, select the other color automatically, which will be changed. Can you see that? So it's very interesting to see, right? So you can change your sheet color into the sheet tab color into a different key. Okay, then we can hide the particular sheet. I'll click on a right click, you can click on a hide. So automatically the sheet will be hiding. If you want to get back of your sheet, you can click on a right click on sheet bar, click on a hide, which sheet you have hided, select it, click on OK. Okay, this is another method you can use. And one more thing I forgot to explain. If you want to move this data and it should be having a copy, you want to copy the data and you want to move somewhere, you can use that. I'll just show you. Right click on it, you can use a copy or move. Select the sheet name which you want to move. I want to move this sheet 1 to mark before the sheet marks 2 1. Okay, marks 2. So I'll select the marks 2. I'll click on a create a copy and click on OK. If I click on a create a copy, mark one will be here, mark sheet one will be here also, and mark sheet will, one will be also will be before the marks two. Okay, click on OK. Can you see that? Yes. Next, we have an next concept. We can go by the select all the sheet. Okay. So if I want to select all the sheets, I can click on a control and I can select the all the sheet. Instead of selecting all the sheet, you can go by the right click and you can click on select all. If you selected the all the sheet, what will be happen? In which sheet you are going to be write the data, automatically it will be copied in other sheets also. For example, see, I selected the all the sheets. I'll show you again one more time. Right click on the sheet, click on select all the sheet, cursor where you want to write the data. For example, I want to create a and salary slip. Okay, I want to write a salary slip, name of the employee. I want to write their salary. I want to write their HR. I want to write their PF, and I want to add their PET. Other tax part I need to add over here. See, once in which sheet I have added, in sheet marks one, in marks one I have added. If you went with the marks two, see, same thing which is then repeated in the sheet two, and same thing which will be repeated in the sheet three. It same will be repeated in the sheet three. So if you are and going to be add the data in all the same sheet, means same column, same row, it should be copied in other sheet also. You can use this method. I'll show one more time. I'll go with the select all the sheets, select all, and I'm going to be add a name of the employee, Anu, Hema, Janu, or other names you can add over here. You can add the salaries of them. Okay, so see, whatever I have written in the part one sheet, sheet one I have written, same thing will be copied in a sheet two, sheet three, and sheet four. Okay, so this is a method you can use by the select all. Okay, then let me see how to use this Excel sheet. Okay, so if you want to insert the data, okay, if you want to insert the date, so you can use a shortcut key to, if you want to insert the date, just a second. Okay, if you want to insert the date, you can use the control plus colon, you can use to insert the date. If you want to insert the time, you can use a control plus shift plus. You can use a colon. This is a shortcut key you can insert for date and time. Just see. So I'll use a control colon. It's a shortcut key to insert the date. If you want to insert the time, you can use a control plus shift plus colon. This is a second method you can use. The one more method you can use, that is that if you want the both the date and time, you can use equals to now, open the bracket, close the bracket, click on enter. There is no need of insert filling, so just you will find the both the date and time. This I'll show you one more. I'll just try the shortcut key. If you want to insert the both time and date, you can use a formula equals to now, open the bracket, close the bracket. This is then one more method you can insert the date and time. This I'll show you. Control colon for inserting of date, control plus shift plus colon for inserting of time. If you want to insert the both rows and both date and time, you can insert the equals to now, open the bracket, close the bracket. This is an inserting of date and time. Now, I want to select the only the particular sheet. You can use a, either you can, if I want to select only the row two, you can use that header bar and you can select it. You can select the row two. Instead of, if I don't want to select using of mouse, you can have a shift plus control Okay, control plus space bar to select the particular column. If you want to select the particular row, shift plus space bar we use to select the particular row and particular column. If you want to select the particular row, we'll be using shift plus, we'll be adding with the space bar. Okay, so if you want to use a particular column, if you want to use, you can use a control plus space bar. Okay, this is the shortcut key. I'm kindly requesting you to all to make a note of it. Next, I'll just show you again. If you want to select the particular row, particular column, control space bar. If you want to select the particular row, you can use a shift plus space bar. Okay, and imagine I have a multiple data. I want to select only from the till this grade. Okay, I want this. So let me copy and paste somewhere. Let me delete this. Okay, so I want to select the row. If I'm working in a workplace, there won't be having a time to select the my mouse. So if you want to select the data by using of my keyboard, you can use your control and you can use your arrow keys. Control, sorry, select the shift plus arrow key. So right arrow key, you can select by the one by one rows and you can select by the one by one columns. Okay, so if you want to select the an entire work day, entire data, you can use the control plus, shift plus, right arrow and down arrow. Okay, so let me again, I will show you. I want to select the data only by the row wise or only by the column wise. You can select the shift, you can use the arrow key for the selecting the particular row or particular column. If you want to use an entire workbook or entire data, if you want to select, you can use a control, shift, right arrow and down arrow. Whatever the data you have created, it will be selected. Okay, so next we have so all this shortcut key have given in your notes. I'll be mailed you or I'll be sent by your WhatsApp group. You just check, you can just check it. Okay, next we can selection is over, drag and drop over. Okay, next I want to insert the data. Just a second. Okay, so how to protect the structure? Okay, for example, the sheet structure I have explained you. For example, here I have a grade column. Nobody has to be fill this grade column. Only I has to be fill this grade column. I am explaining how to protect the particular structure. Okay, or I want nobody has to be change this percentage. So I want to protect only this structure. How to protect it? I'm just explaining. Okay, if you want to protect the particular structure, you need to freeze the. You need to click on protection. But individual cell is defaultly protected. So if you want to unprotect it, you need to click on select all, or you can click on control A to select all. Click on outside. Click on control all. Click on right click on it. Click on format cell and go to protection. It will be automatically locked. Can you see over here? Each and every cell in our Excel, it is a defaultly locked. Click on unlock. Click on OK. Okay. So now select the data which you want to be protected, or which you select the range which you want to be protected. And again, you click on right click on the sheet tab. Click on a format cell, click on pro locker, click on okay. Okay, now even though it's not has been protected, you can go by the sheet tab, click on a protection, sheet protection, give a password, re-enter the password, click on okay. Now can you see that you can be alter at the outer side, you can be alter at the outside, you can't be alter in a where you have freeze in a structure. Okay, can you see that? You can't be alter over here. It's not allowing me to alter. Why? Because I have protected the particular structure. Okay, just I'll show you one more time. Now I'll add a same thing. So here I have some data in the total column. I'll auto sum it, or I'll use a formula to sum. If you want to sum this data, and you can use a formula. It is an alt equals to, that is an auto sum. Just a second, I'll unprotect the sheet. Okay, I'll cursor over here. Alt equals, automatically it will be auto sum. There is no need of equals to assigning your selecting your range or assigning your data. There is no need. If there is an automatic calculation, that is an auto sum, you can use. It is an alt equals to. You can use that formula. Alt equals to, alt plus equals to, use it for auto sum. Okay, auto sum shortcut key, alt equals. See, right now I have a data. Nobody has to be change this. And can you see that at the formula bar, I have given the data. I can view the formula. Nobody has to be know that which formula I have presented in this particular cell, so that I can be hide it. How to hide? Just I'll show you. You can select the data. Already we have unprotected the overall workbook. I'll right click on my sheet. I click on a format cell. Select the protection. Click on locker. Click on OK. And select the which cell you can't be. You should not be show your formula. Right click on it. Protect the format cell. Click on also the hide. Click on OK. Now still it's also showing. I'll just hide the sheet. Right click on the sheet tab. Click on a format sheet. Click on a password 123. Give a re-enter the password 123. Click on OK. Now can you see the formula which I have given auto sum? Here, see, it's not showing any formula. See, and you can't be edited over here. The outside you can be edited, outside you can change the data, but here you can't be change anything and you can't be see any kind of formula, that is an hiding. Okay, these are the tricks you can use while you are working. So here just I'll show you the some of the practicals for you. You have to do this practical and you need to submit or you need to send this by the next class. The next class will be on by Monday. So you need to send this assignment. Just take a screenshot or you can take this. I'll mail you through WhatsApp. I'll send by this through WhatsApp. You can collect this. These are the assignment. You must do this assignment and you need to be send it by the next class. Okay. Next class is nothing but on by the Saturday you must send it. On by the Monday you need to send this. See over here. Here I have given the assignment. Whatever today I have explained you, same thing I have given over here. Protect the, create and workbook. Create a workbook and protect the workbook by the password 1234. And here I have a insert and 12 sheets and name it as a month, like in January, February, and March. And one more thing I have, change the sheet tab color. I have explained you previously now. And protect the sheet. And you have a protect the sheet. It is in January sheet you need to protect. It is and by the password of DSC. And you need to insert the range, that is an in a A1 to A10 sheet. You need to arrange, you need to insert the, you need to protect the ranges. Okay, how to protect the ranges? Just I have showed you right now. You can use this one. Okay, just I'll show you how to do this one. So here I have given you create a new workbook. Okay, let me open window or open by the Excel. Click on OK. You'll find a new workbook. Okay, click on the maximize. Okay, let me know with other. Okay, in that you need to go with the save it by your name. So what you want to say this? You want to save this workbook by your name. I'll just show you how to save this. Go with the file, go with the save. Okay, or if it's not asking save, say click on a save as, click on a browse, click on a document or desktop, wherever you want. Give the file name as your name. Why? Because I'm sending what I have. Why because I have given a name. You can, if whatever you'll in, sorry, whatever you'll give a name, according to it I'll give a internal marks for you. So I'm requesting you to create the file or create a workbook on your name. Okay, say the workbook on your name, click on save. Okay, so then you can third, you need to protect your workbook by the password of 1234. Get back to your workbook and go to file, go to info, click on protect workbook, click on protect, sorry, go to file, go to info, protect workbook, encrypt with password. Here you have a password, click on 1234, save the file, 1234, click on okay. Okay, so then save again. The first question has been completed, first practical is completed. Second one, insert the 12 sheets. You know that how to insert the 12, insert the 12 sheet. You can click on plus. Now right now I have a 6 or 10 and a half. You can click on plus or you can click on F12. So, and I have given that name the sheets on as month, like in January, like in February, you can change it. Just see, I'm going to be change the sheet name, like in January, you can fill the full name, you can give a February, and you can fill the March. Like this, you need to change the sheet name. And the third, I have given that, change the sheet name as in month. Okay, we have completed. Next, you need to do change each sheet tab colors. Okay, what you want to change a sheet, you need to change the sheet tab colors. Get back to your sheet. So right click on the sheet tab, click on a tab color, change the color of the sheet. Okay, right click on each sheet and you need to give a different color. If it's black also you can give, automatically it will change, and for the font color, yes, we need to change the individual sheets. And you know that you need to change the sheet name into the month. 12 month sheets also you need to be created. Okay, then you need to be protect the sheet of January. Which sheet you need to protect? We have protected the workbook. That isn't different. And protect the sheet is different. Go to sheet. You need to protect the January sheet. So you need to select the Jan sheet. So if you are in sheet 9 or if you are in December sheet, if you are protected, I won't give any marks. So you need to go by the January and to go by the file, you need to go by the info, you need to go by the protection, protect the current sheet, give a password which I have given over there, DSC, same as it is, you need to provide it. Click on OK. Re-enter the password, click on OK. The sheet Jan has been protected. The third, you need to protect the range. Okay, which one you need to protect? You need to protect the range. It is an A1 to A10. Okay, so that already right now I have explained you. And also, you need to hide the content in the range. Just now I have showed you how to hide the content. Okay, so this protect the range has to be given the password by the NICT. Okay, so for the protecting workbook, I have given a 1 to 4. I have given the protecting the sheet, I have given the different kind of password, and protecting the particular structure or particular range, I have given over here NICT. Okay, you need to follow the same password. Okay, let me come back. So I'll need to protect this structure in which sheet they have told, in a sheet of February. So let me go with the sheet path, select the sheet which you select the range. Range is nothing but set of cells. So this one cell is called as a, this one block is called as a cell. Okay, if you want to, range is nothing but a set of cell. Okay, If you want to select, you need to select the set of cell and click on a right click on it, click on a format cell. Sorry. First of all, you need to unprotect all the sheet, all the cells, select all the sheet, right click on it, click on a format cell, unlock the all the cells, click on OK, and select the cell which you want to protect it or which you want to authenticate the range, click on a locker, click on OK. Okay. Now still it's not time protected and I have given to hide it. So right click on it, go back to format cell. Here you can see the hide it. Click on hide, click on OK. Okay. Now you need to protect it by the sheet protection. Right click on it, protect the sheet, give a password and re-enter the password. Click on OK. Okay. Like this, you can be saved. So this is your practical class. So I'll practical questions. So who will not send this practical workbook? I won't give any internal marks for them. So all you have to be save the data on your name and it should be sent it to your WhatsApp group, which has sending the link, right? On the same group, you need to be send your practicals, okay? Practical workbook you need to send by the same WhatsApp group. Okay, just the, all the notes I have given over here. You can go through this. Here have an all the shortcut key have given here. Don't worry. So how to open the workbook? What are the in Excel elements? And we have an way of editing. Last class I have explained you this three types of ways of editing. And we have an how to insert the sheets have given over here. A RAN between, how to use a RAN between we have over here. How to how many sheets we have? How many rows we have? How many columns we have? Less. I just explained you. And how to move your sheet? I have given the steps. Have given the notes over here. You can follow this. Okay. Minimize shortcut key. Maximize shortcut key. Save. Undo. Redo. Save as. Close shortcut key. How to encrypt the document? How to decrypt the document? How to protect the sheet? How to protect the particular range? And you open all the shortcut key I have given over here. You can go with it. Okay. I'll send by your WhatsApp group. Okay. So any doubts you have, you can ask with you can just raise, you can ask by the chat box. Okay. Ma'am, we have to make the video and send to you just by the practical picture. Ma'am, we have to make the video. No, but don't make any video. I'm requesting you to create on your you need to create by the workbook and you need to send it. Okay. If you have a doubts, you can ask by the chat box. You can ask. Ma'am, can we please repeat the protection and range again? Ma'am, I didn't get it. Okay. So I'll again explain how to protect the range and how to protect. So there'll be a three type. Last steps of assignment of the protection. Yeah. Okay. I'll just show you the all the again three types of all the again protections. So we have a file. Under the file, we have a different kind of protections. You can see over here. Read only mode, encrypt with the password, protect the current sheet, protect the structure. Open read only mode, it will allow you to edit the data, but once if we open the data, yes, I'll send the mail also. Just see over here, if you want to open by the read only mode, you can open by this. Okay, so then you have encrypt with the password. encrypt with password is protecting of over of your workbook. We have a protect current sheet. Yes, protect the current sheet will be protected only the particular sheet which you have selected. So if I have entered the minimum 4 to 5 sheet under which sheet you have selected, that sheet will be protected. Protect the workbook structure. The structure of workbook will be protected. Means it won't allow you to write, or it won't allow you to insert the sheet or in deleting of sheet, it won't allow you to edit it. Okay. So let me show you one more time how to protect that. Yes, I'll send. You can send the assignment through WhatsApp group. Okay, which he has been sending by the link. In which group I am sending the link? Same in that group I am requesting you to send the and your assignments. Okay, all the person has to be sent who will send the an assignment for them. I'll give a internal marks. Otherwise, I won't give a internal marks. Okay, so I'll just show you the protection. Okay, let me go by the how to protect. That is an encrypt with password. It will ask the password 1, 2, 3. Re-enter the password. It can give a alpha and a numeric, both you can give. I can see protect the current sheet also is protected. Workbook is also protected. Okay, so if you want to remove that, you can come back. You can remove your password. You can click on OK. Same as it is. If you want to remove your protect sheet, you can go over here. But here you need to manually enter your password. In a workbook protection, there will be a dotted kind of password. You can erase it and you can save the file. But in a protection of workbook, a worksheet particularly, it will be manually we used to give it. Okay. So this is two kinds. So how to protect the structure? So see, here I can add a sheets over here. You can see that I can plus it or I can delete it. Right click on a sheet, you can delete it. But in the structure of protection, okay, in the structure of protection, it won't allow you to add or delete. So I'll go by the info, I'll go with the protection. I click on a protect particular structure, click on a password, they re-enter the password. Now see, it won't allow. Can you see that plus that sheet adder is a hidden? Okay, so if I want to delete it also, see, right click on it. So you can see that protect the sheet, it's there. You can't be deleted, you can't be renamed, you can't be moved. This is different forms we have in a protecting the structure, a protecting a protection. So let me go with the how to protect a particular range. See, here I have a sum of the data. I'll use the auto sum. Auto sum means an automatic calculation. Okay, so automatically it will total the value. There is a shortcut key, you can use a alt plus equals to. Okay, now nobody has to be changed this value. First of all, the sheet means first of all the all the individual cell will be locked. So see, if I write the data anything over there, see for example, write the NICT. If I come out of that, if I select, if I want to add some data with NICT, for example, I want to add a NICT with education. See, if I write it, the education, it will be overwritten. Means the NICT will be removed, education will be returned. So automatically, all the cells will be blocked. If you want to remove that locker, you can select all. You can see that header bar we have. It is an A, row name and the column name. You can select that header or you can use the control A to select all. Okay, which you need to come to the and blank cell. You need to click on control A and right click on the sheet. You will be having a format cell. Okay, click on a format cell. Under that, you can go by the protection. The C, you can see it's a locker defaultly. You need to remove that locker. Click on OK. And select the structure which should be a locker. Select on format cell. Click on protection. If you don't want to display the data in a formula bar or nobody has to know the formula what you have written, you can click on hide. This hide button which helps you to lock the cell means it won't display which formula I have used. Okay, so click on OK. Okay. Next, you need to protect the sheet. You can go by the file, or you can click on a right click on a sheet only. You can go with the protect the sheet. You can type over there. So password. Re-enter the password. Now see. So I have done the formula that is an autosum. You can't view the data on the name box. Can you see that? The data is not viewing. So if I click on education, it's showing. If I selected this 832, that is in total of your Kannada subject, it's not showing. Why? Because we have hided that one. Okay. Any other doubts you have? Any other doubts you have? You can ask if you have any other doubts. You can ask by the chat box. You can ask. So in the form of photo, ma'am. No, you all has to be sent by the Excel workbook only. There is no photo. I don't want any photocopy of it. Okay. I think I'm clear for you. I think in this nobody have a doubt. When is the last day to submit? Within Monday you need to submit it. Within Monday you need to submit it. So I have given, someone has said, ma'am, how will you save from which name we have sent it? Yes, I have given the practical question. You just can check it. What the assignment I have given. Question have given. I given that save your document by the, save your workbook by the name, your name. Save it as your name. So you have to save it your name and you need to send it. Okay. So I need an individual participations. So according to it, I'll give you internal marks. Okay. So let me view other things. So here we have completed the some of the few concepts. We have used how to edit the view inside the sheets. All the things we have completed. Yes. If you have any doubts, yes. Okay. Thank you. I think there is no doubt in a practical. You can do. You can all can do, and you can send it to. Through your personal your WhatsApp number. Now show the assignment page. Yes, again I'll show you the assignment page. You can take this screenshot, or I'll send you this. Yes, I'll send you this by the WhatsApp groups. You can use it. I'll send the notes and I'll send the assignments through WhatsApp group. Yes, fine. Whoever have a doubt, if you can practice, you'll get by the doubt. So whoever can having a doubt, you can ask the questions by the chat box. Okay. So all of you should practice, and I'm requesting you to all to practice by the individually. So means. How to hide the ribbons, how to activate the quick access toolbar, how to send the mail, and how to save the file. Say what is the difference between save as and the save, how to convert this into the PDF format, and how to use that template. Last class only you have used it. Who have not used the template, you can use that, ma'am. We have to transfer our assignments to the mobile number sent to me. Yes. Yes, of course, you need to send the assignments, which is in a group only you can send it. So next, need to use this sheet tab, how to insert the sheet, and right click of all the sheet tab. That is an extra option, that is an insert, delete, rename, move, copy, view, and protection, tab color. And you need to use this, is then very essential in a WordPress. This is then selection, select all the sheets. If you use this command, it will be helpful for the future also. Okay, this, then any others, any other doubts? Okay, I think no one has a doubt. Okay, fine. So then I'll be continue on by the next class on by the Monday. Before Monday, all you has to be send it through WhatsApp. Who are not sending, I won't give any internal marks for them. Okay. Just a second. I'll just show you the pay special concept. Okay. So this pay special in the home tab, I'll just explain a few things. We have a paste, we have a cut, copy, format, painter. We have a bold, italic, underline. These are the other, every, you can't review this other concepts in a file tab. We have other extra concepts over in a home tab. You can see in a home, we have a commands. Under the commands, we have a groups. And I forgot to explain, this is a dialog box. In a dialog box, you'll be having an extra concepts over here. For example, see, here I have a bold, italic, underline, and increasing of font, decreasing of font. But you can see in this dialog box, you will be having a strike, will be having an superscript, will be having a subscript. Even though we have upper, lower, underline, coloring of over here, so you'll get an extra options over in a dialog box. This is called as a dialog box. Okay, so let me view here also clipboard. We have in the clipboard, if you want to use the paste, and if you want the paste options, you can select over here. Okay, so let me show that. If I want to add a date, I'll add a name over here, some name of the student, some marks or total marks, or imagine it's a salary name, salary. Okay, so I'll add a name over here. Some have created some of the custom list. I'll select the name of Divya. If I drag and drop, I'll use this fill holder. So automatically will be filled. How to use this, I'll explain it later to what. And you can add a salary. Okay, you can select the name. Name should be always highlighted. You can select the name. Under the name, you have a home. Under the home, you can you can make an highlighting by the you can highlight the name and salary by using of this highlighter. This is a font color. You can change the font color. If you want to give a border of this data, you can select the data. You can click on a border. Okay, so all border, if you are given, it will be assigned the all the border. You want an only the outside border, you can click on outside border. If you don't want the all the border, you can click on no border automatically, which will be a remote. So if you want only the outline, I don't want an all the side, you can change it. Okay. And it's in bold, all the text should be assigned the bold. You can assign the bold. If you want in a italic, you can assign the italic. If you want to change in an underline, all the text should be underlined. You can change in an underline. Okay. Clipboard, all the things I'll be explaining in the next class. Okay. Okay, I'll be, if you have any doubts, you can ask. So if you have a doubt, you can ask. Who have a doubt regarding to today class? In admin group, you can't be texted. You just need to transfer your data to admin group. Yes. Fine. If you have any doubts, you can ask with me. All I'm requesting you to make a note of this. Make a note of the shortcut keys and this. I'm requesting you to make this shortcut key. Make a note of this shortcut key, which will be used regularly in all the Microsoft Office. In all the Microsoft Office applications, we can use this. I hope you have all been done it. So all you can take a screenshot of it or you can make a note of it. I think you have been taken. So let me go with the next concept. Yes, we have a few concepts that I'll do with it. We have a format painter. Just I'll show you this format painter. So see, in a name box, in a cell of A2, I have highlighted by the highlighting a cell. I have given a different font color. I have given italic. I have given underline. I changed the font color. A font style I have changed. The same thing which has to be copy to the salary. You can select the name. You can click on a format painter once. You can click on a salary automatically, which will be filled in a salary. Okay. So again, I'll show you how to fill this. The same thing. You need to select the particular word or particular cell. Click on a format painter. Select the text. It should be follow the same formatting in the next cell. Okay. Select the particular cell. Click on a format painter and click on the cell. The same thing which will be used and regularly means it will be used for the multiple times. Select the cell which you want to be formatted. Double tap on it. Double tap on the format painter. And you will be getting a brush icon format. You just select whichever cell you want to be formatted. Okay. This is a format painter. So you can make a note. Format painter will be used to copy the same format to the other plain text. If you want to copy the formatting with the same with other text, you can use this format painter. Okay. So we have a cut. We know that cut is, and we'll use the, for example, I want to remove this name from this A1 cell. You can select the name. You can click on a cut. If I want over here, you can cursor here and you can paste it. Okay. So there is a two types of way you can cut or you can copy. Cut, it will remove from here, and copy, it will replace there and it will be pasted in other place. Okay, you can see that it is pasting other place. Cut, it will be remain same and it will be pasted in other. So cut, it will remove from that place and it will be pasted in other places. Copy, it will be remove that particular from that. Copy, it will be remain same and it will be pasted in a other sheet also. Okay, that is a cut. Copy, we have a paste, and a paste we have a multiple kinds of paste. Like can paste as an normal paste, as in without formula, paste as a numbering formatting, paste as in keep source formatting, and we have a without border, we have an keep source column, and we have a transpose and value, and we have a value with formatting with, like we have a source formatting. And we have a other kind paste as a team without formatting, with only without data, without formatting. We can paste like an image, we can paste the link as an image. So like we have a different kind of pastings. Okay, so this we'll see on by the next class. Okay, so I'm all requesting you to practice this all the tabs which has been completed. We have completed the screen elements, we have completed the file, and we have completed the sheet tab. Okay, sheet tab we have completed. So all this used to be before next class. You need to be practice before. I'm going to be start the class by the next day, on by the Monday. You can ask the doubts, whatever the doubts you have, you can raise by the chat box, and I'll clear it and I'll go by the next class. Okay, next class I'll do this page special, another font and alignment, this condition formatting. Okay, so see you on by the next class on by the Monday. Okay, same as it is, 3 to 4. I think all are clear. Any doubts you have, you can add by the chat box. If you don't have any doubts, I'll close the schedule. I mean, I'll log out from the Zoom. We'll end the session. So whoever have a doubt, if you are clear, click on send as an okay. Who are not clear, whoever have a doubt, you can write by the chat command. Ma'am, after setting the password, we have compulsory have save. Ma'am, after setting the password, we have the compulsory save. Yes, of course, you need to give a password, and I have given an individual kind of password that only have to be provided. Don't confuse with it. Well, we are opening the workbook. For workbook, 1, 2, 3, 4 is a password. And for the protection of particular January sheet, you need to give some DS key. And for the protecting of structure, you need to give an NS key. The same password you need to be follow. Any other doubts? I think no one has a doubt. Okay. So shall we continue on by the next class on by the Monday, same as it is, ma'am, the password side. Okay, I'll send you that I'll send you all the passwords, don't worry, through WhatsApp. Okay, just send by the right now only, you can use it. So all you can check in admin group, I have sent the notes and the also the today's assignment. It should be presented on by the which should be sent it before on Monday. Okay, before Monday you need to send through your WhatsApp group. Okay, I think no one has an doubt. Okay, let me wind the session. We'll be going to be see on by the next class. Okay, on my Monday. Thank you. See you. Bye.